Now let's get to some notable executive changes for Nasdaq, with two division leaders moving up to president level. Those moves coming in the aftermath of a significant restructuring last year, the business reorganizing into three divisions. Yahoo Finance's Brian Sazi, our executive editor, is joining us from the exchange with the two individuals in question. Brian?
All right. Thanks so much, Julie. Yes, joining me now is Tal Cohen and Nelson Griggs, the new co-presidents of Nasdaq. Congratulations to you both on the position. And Tal, I'll start with you because your last name begins with C. I want to give you both equal time here. Okay, it's the only way I can figure out how to do it. Now, like we just mentioned in our opener, you just stood up a new structure in late September, dividing the businesses in different segments. What will this change in structure now allow you to do?
Yeah, so this announcement today is really formalizing that realignment we announced late last year and put in place at the beginning of this year. And it really starts with the DNR, who took on the chair position in addition to the CEO position, and that elevated her. And then at the beginning of the year, we also talked about three key themes we wanted to lean into, and those themes were liquidity, transparency, and integrity. And so then we reorganized our businesses around those key themes. And so my division, Market Platforms, is going to focus on liquidity. And that's around market modernization and the transformation of financial services. Nelson has the privilege of leading Capital Access Platforms that's going to focus on transparency. And that's about really the solutions that are driving insights and intelligence for corporates and investors. And the last one we have being led by Brennan Brothers, which is our anti-financial crime unit, is all about integrity and the integrity of the market. So we think about the protection, the safety, and the integrity of the financial system, because that drives adoption and growth. And so we're thinking these three themes are going to accelerate our growth going forward.
Nelson, if one is an investor in Nasdaq out there, they see this new structure stood up, how does your day-to-day change and what will you be working on?
Well, I think hopefully the structure for our investors makes it a bit more clear what we're going after, these mega trends that Tal highlighted, that is really on anti-financial crime. It's where the modernizing the markets, then in my group, it's how do you provide more data and insights to both investors and corporates. So I think our vision is a lot clearer today in terms of what we're going after. And then also from a customer standpoint, I think that was a big focus here. How do customers want to work with Nasdaq? And we thought combining these business units into divisions makes it a bit clearer to customers. And the last piece is a ton of time on employees. So this does give us a lot of opportunity to think about employee growth, how they're going to think about Nasdaq as a place to work for a long period of time.
I imagine there's a big discussion of AI. You look outside, there was, I believe, AI on a listing recently or today at the Nasdaq. I'll put it to you, Tal. How does AI change your business? How will it modernize your business moving forward?
Yeah, so Nasdaq's been employing AI for quite some time across all of our different divisions. And so we see application across my division, Nelson's division, and anti-financial crime. I'll start with anti-financial crime. Verafin's business is being powered by AI. So they have this network, all this data they're taking advantage of, and it's context aware to help their clients detect fraud. So that's really powerful, drives a lot of value. In my business for Market Platforms, we're looking at AI in the following ways. One is we just put in place something called a dynamic strike program. So we're trying to be really intelligent about capacity management so that our clients can benefit from that. So things that we can take out of the market, because they're just taking up capacity without adding value, allows us to do two things. One is ensure the resilience of the market, but two, when we put out new product, we've developed more capacity for that product by taking out products that are not as valuable and don't really drive the resilience we want to see in a market.
Does AI make the markets riskier? Be because it's run by machines and that requires certain inputs?
Yeah, so we've been really thoughtful about that, thought about that a lot. So we want to make sure that whenever we put out AI or anything that's really context aware or dynamic, we're doing the right amount of testing, we're putting guardrails in place, and we're working with our clients really, really closely, as well as our regulators, to understand the impact it could have on markets, especially if it's a real-time application, because that is a different set of circumstances versus something that might be looking at historical data.
Nelson, you were still leading the listings business?
Yes, I
am. Okay, so in terms of listings, what do you see in terms of AI listings over the next year? Are there a lot of these companies calling you up saying, we're going to come to market, there's a lot of chatter, a lot of hotness around this space. How do you see it?
Yeah, I think the hotness today is much more in the VC community. So if you were going out to the Valley or really, you know, the global VC area, there's a lot of money going into AI, because if you think about the applicability, it is seen as something that, you know, across all industries is going to be transformative. So I think more there than saying, hey, I'm ready to go public, you know, next year. Now, there's certainly some that have been around for a while now that are thinking about that, but this new wave, this new enthusiasm is probably a little more dated than that.
Got about 25 seconds left. I'll leave on this. Tal, best leadership advice you ever got, considering you are now in this role?
Adaptability and flexibility. You need to be adaptable and flexible, and that's the organization we're trying to draw. The agility is key to our success going forward.
Nelson?
How about we'll go with client listening. So our big theme is around what makes sense for clients, where do they want us to go? And we think what we develop here in this structure is where they want us to go. So we're excited about how to listen to our clients.
All right, well, congrats on these promotions. Tal Cohen, good to see you. Nelson Griggs, good to see you as well. Julie, Brad, back to you.